Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're watching this, congratulations to us because you made it to another vlog. So I know I've been missing in action lately. Dami ko lang ganap these past few days. I missed out some weeks when I was supposed to upload a new vlog, but yeah, life happened. I'm pretty swamped with my work, with my part-time job, and also doing household chores, aka adulting. You know what I mean? You understand what I'm trying to say? So please bear with me, guys. I'm back with another vlog. I'm back with a new video for everyone. So yeah, don't worry. I'm trying to upload vlogs as much as I can. And hindi ko naman pababayaan yung YouTube community ko. So I hope you continuously support me. Alright? Anyway, I know yesterday was Chinese New Year, right? So happy Chinese New Year to everyone. And for those who did not celebrate, I hope you make use of this time to take some rest, get a good sleep, and think of ways how you can motivate yourself and be the best version of yourself for this year, which is, by the way, aligned with what we are going to talk about today. So, yon, you know how the first part of the year always feels like the right time to start afresh, start new beginnings, or leave old bad habits. Yun yung pag-uusapan natin today. We're going to talk about how to be the best version of yourself by following the 5-second rule. 5 seconds lang. So if you're interested, just keep on watching. So the 5-second rule is actually a concept based on a book by Mel Robbins. The book was published in 2017. So once you decide to follow this 5-second rule concept, it will change your life, it will change the way you work, basically the process of how you do your daily routine. Okay, it's like a life model wherein every time your inner self tells you to do something, you act on it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's the 5-second rule. You count 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, then boom, you act on it. You act on your goal right there and then. Classic example, sa umaga, my work starts very early. It starts at 6 a.m. So, of course, I still have to prepare and do all my morning routine. Kaya, bumabangon ako ng prior 6 a.m. So, every time my alarm goes on, automatically, I hit the snooze button until I realize that I'm already late. So, which is a very, very bad habit of mine because number one, I do not get to finish all the things that I have to do for that day, and I don't get to finish it on time. And then number two is that, syempre, salary deduction yun because late nga ako eh. Another example, kapag ka naisipan mo mag-workout, diba? Ay sige, mag-workout ako ngayong araw. Tapos maisip mo after a while, ay manonood muna pala ako ng ano, bagong episode ng Korean drama na pinapanood ko. 1 episode lang, tapos 2 episodes, 3 episodes, hanggat hindi mo na siya nagawa. And then another example, pag may kailangan kang ipasa na file or project sa colleague mo, ay mamaya ako napapasa, maaga pa naman. Pag ano na, bago mag 6 p.m, ganun, pag uwian na. Puro mamaya na, hanggang sa hindi mo na nagagawa yung mga dapat mong gawin. Ang daming excuses, you have a lot of reasons that are stopping you from doing all the things that you have to finish. If you do the 5-second rule concept consistently, amazing things will happen in your life. Trust me. So every time you get an inspired instinct to act on a goal, you must act on it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, then physically move, or else your brain will stop you. Tulad ng mga examples na binigay ko kanina. The ultimate game of life is to close the gap between where you're currently at and where you want to be. So this gap, this space between those two, it is where the laziness lies, it's where the mañana habit lies, and it's where all the negative energy lies. So what you can do to close that gap is to practice the 5-second rule. Kapag may naisip kang gawin, gawin mo na, right there and then. If gusto mong gumaling sa TikTok, practice mo lahat ng dance steps ng TikTok. Diba? If you want to learn a new language, go ahead, practice that language. If you want to learn how to play an instrument, go buy that guitar, go buy that piano, and then start practicing. You have to work on yourself. Kailangan mo siyang gawin right there and then. Don't wait for anything else. Don't let your brain stop you. The 5-4-3-2-1 rule is a very simple yet very powerful tool that you can use to be the best version of yourself. Diba parang sarap sa feeling ng nag-make progress, nagkakaroon ka ng improvement. So allow yourself to feel that power. Allow yourself to feel that greatness. The next key point is how to win the game of life. Well, the secret is to stay in the game. Play the long game. Dito na rin po pasok yung rejections and failures. So even after doing the 5-second rule, then you fail or you get rejected by someone, just keep doing what you're doing. Somewhere along the way, you will find out the areas where you are wrong. Reason being for failing. But keep doing what you're doing. Get rejected, but start doing it again, diba? The next thing that you should do after being rejected or after failing is to start over again. Start in the beginning and then act on it. And then if you fail, do the same thing. This is the same method that the most successful people did. You think they were born smart? They were born perfect? Of course not. They were inspired by something and then they trained themselves. They practiced their skills, they read books until they got the formula on how to make it right. So it's okay to be rejected. It's okay to fail. It's all part of the process. You also have to align your mind and body. You have to deeply implant the attributes of the best version of yourself. And then, align it with your body. Kailangan susunod din yung katawan mo. Hindi pwede nasa isip mo lang. Kailangan sumunod din yung katawan mo, your movement, how you will act on it. Kapag ka nga nagsisale sa Lazada or sa Shopee, automatically, we scroll down through our phone, we navigate the app, parang automatic na sumusunod yung katawan natin. Sometimes, even without our brain telling us to do so, right? So, apply the same principle to the process on becoming the best version of yourself. Do not let your brain to stop you or paralyze you from creating amazing things, from being the best version of yourself. Third key point is turning anxiety into excitement. So both are in the same section of high arousal energy. It's just that anxiety is in the negative area and excitement is in the positive side. So imagine this, when you're about to do something that makes you nervous, instead of saying, calm down, it's okay, you can do it, try telling yourself, I am excited, over and over again until you believe in it. This is a proven technique, guys. Ha? Hindi ko to inimbento kahapon, okay? Hindi to pucho-pucho lang. When you tell yourself that I am excited, it automatically reframes your anxiety, which is a negative high arousal energy, into excitement. Excitement kasi is a feeling that something good is about to happen to you. So try saying I am excited every time you're about to perform or every time you're about to present to a big group of people or when you're about to do something for the first time, it will automatically take away the feeling or the thought that something is wrong with you, that something is lacking in you. So I highly suggest to interpret anxiety as excitement so that you can perform better. Fourth key point is to stay focused. I know this is something easier said than done, but the easiest way to stay focused and be focused is to get rid of all the distractions, meaning your TV, your cell phone, all your gadgets, Netflix, Instagram, Facebook, lahat yan, get rid of them. Turn off that notification button because if you don't, you will get distracted very easily and you do not have to check your phone every spare time you get, okay? Hindi mo kailangan palaging i-check kung may bagong status yung crush mo, may bagong live yung pinafollow mo sa IG, or kung may bagong post mo sa Facebook, you do not have to do that every spare time that you get. Beside that, being focused and staying focused is much more important than being distracted by all these notifications, all these gadgets. Last but not the least is that one moment. So, seize that inspired instinct, okay? Make use of that 5-second rule that can change your life, it can change how you work, and it could also probably change the whole world. So that one moment sums up everything that we have discussed today. That's the 5-second rule, how to win the game of life, transforming anxiety into excitement, and then how to stay focused, and last but not the least, that one moment. So I hope you're able to find value in what I have shared with you today, with what I have talked about. in this episode. Gusto ko sabay-sabay tayong mag-grow, sabay-sabay nating gawin lahat ng dreams and goals natin. And I hope you will apply this 5-second rule into your daily routine so that you can be the best version of yourself. Alright? Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and comment down below your thoughts and opinion about today's topic and kung ano pa yung gusto niyo mapanood na content in my upcoming vlogs. Alright? That's it. See you next week!